Welcome to the Blazor Data Form tutorial. Here, I will show you how to get started with the Syncfusion Blazor Data Form component. It simplifies form creation by automating field setup, layout customization, and data binding, enhancing development for both simple and complex models with flexibility for customization. Before proceeding, make sure that you have one of the following .NET SDKs installed in your machine, and one of the IDs installed. After installing the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, I select the Blazor WebAssembly application. Then provide the project name and location. I'll proceed to create a project with the .NET 7.0 framework. Now the default application is ready to use. If you want to know more about the Blazor WebAssembly app and how to add Syncfusion components to it, check out the video linked in the above YouTube card. Now I will show you how to add Syncfusion Blazor Data Form component step by step. First, I need to install the Syncfusion Blazor Data Form NuGet package into my application. So, I open the NuGet package manager. Switch to Browse tab. Search for Syncfusion Blazor Data Form and install the latest version. Also install the latest version of Syncfusion Blazor themes to host the script and CSS files. After completing the installation, I navigate to the imports Razor file. Here I include the Syncfusion Blazor Data Form namespace, allowing me to utilize the Blazor Data Form component within the Pages folder. Next, I open the program CS file and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Also, I register the Syncfusion Blazor service. Next, I need to refer to the CSS reference in the application to work on the Blazor Data Form component. Therefore, navigate to the index.html file and refer to the CSS file from the installed package. I also referenced the script here. Now everything is configured, let me proceed to add the Syncfusion Blazor Data Form. For that, I need to open index.razor file. And here I define the Blazor Data Form component, with form header named Event Registration Form by replacing the default code. Next, I will start to populate the data for the data form. Inside the code block, here I plan to display the employee details in the event registration form. Therefore, let me define the model class named Employee Details. Inside the class, I add the appropriate fields like first name, last name, email, and date of birth. Additionally, I create the object named Employee Detail of type Employee Details and assigned an array of object to it. Then I bind the employee detail to the model property within the Syncfusion Blazor Data Form component. Inside the Data Form component, define the container of form items, providing a structured way to organize different elements. Within the form items, define the form auto-generate items element. It is automatic generation of form items based on the properties of the employee details class. I also apply the CSS style for controller header and wrapper. Let's run the example application. Look here, when I set the name as and in the email field, there is no validation message for incorrect value for that field. So next, let's see how to validate the data form. First, I'll introduce the form validator tag within the Syncfusion data form, indicating the addition of validation to the form. Inside the form validator, I define the data annotations validator tag. It is likely responsible for validating form input based on data annotations applied to the employee details class properties. Next, I will add the validation. To do this, I include the data annotations namespace, allowing us to utilize the validation attributes. Moving on, inside the Employee Details class, I set the required attributes with error messages for all the fields. It is required for the form submission, if it's not filled in, the provided error message will be displayed. Then I add the display attribute above all the fields. It sets the display name for the fields. Additionally, I add the email address attribute with error message above the email field. This attribute validates that the email field contains a properly formatted email address. If the format is incorrect, the specified error message will be shown. Look now, as you can see the provided display name. Now I will demonstrate the validation when I click the Submit button without filled the email and date of birth. Notice that the error is displayed. However, upon filling in the required fields, the form submits without errors. If I incorrectly format the email and submit it, an error is displayed. Now let me summarize what I covered in this video. I covered creating a Blazor WebAssembly app, installing NuGet packages, and implementing Syncfusion Blazor Data Form with validations. If you would like to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free community license to use all our Blazor products. If you find this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.